to take on your own life out of high school.
What was I gonna say again?
You should keep that in.
But before you guys go, I hope you enjoy the video that we put together.
Oppan Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Oppan Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Oppan Gangnam Style.
What is the funniest high school memory you have?
I think that would be in PE 8 where we lost a frisbee in the lake, and I can't remember who it was, but one of my boys stripped down naked.
Oh yeah, yeah, that was Chad. Where is the worst place you could be in 10 years from now?
Here.
We're the three best friends that anybody could have. We're the three best friends that anybody could have.
If you were trapped on a desert island, what teacher would you most likely choose to be with, and why?
Mr. Challen.
Mhm.
Because even when he doesn't know what he's talking about, I feel like he has a confidence to seem like he does.
Aww.
Hey, Mr. Howard, because he knows everything.
Kozak.
Why?
Because he can actually survive.
Call him Mr. Howard, because he knows how to put a fire.
Who was your very first high school crush?
Mr. Howard, just kidding.
Probably Alex Baxter.
Yeah, I honestly think it was too.
Everyone liked Alex Baxter.
Yeah.
Great eight.
Yeah.
What was your favorite high school moment?
Getting out.
No. Hasn't happened yet because it's graduation day. Teacher quote?
Yeah.
Ilnia, pas de miracle.
Stop me no hash, she said.
Where do you think you'll be in 10 years?
Here.
Seaton?
Hopefully, I will be done school and be somewhere awesome.
Calgary.
Ew. I'll be in like Ireland.
Ooh, yeah, that one's good.
Yeah.
Who's your first high school crush?
Dun dun dun.
Definitely Mr. Spock.
Classic.
Channing Tatum.
Well, mine are real people, so let's go. Alex Baxter, Dakota Rook, Nick Griffey, James Shepherd. That pretty much sums it up.
Who is your favorite teacher and why?
Miss McKay, because she's awesome. She's a great cooking teacher.
What is the best pickup line that would work on you?
How you doing?
How you doing? How you doing? How you doing?
I'm doing good, baby. How you doing?
Funniest class memory. French. Is that French 10? When all the boys flew the paper airplanes directly to the teacher. It was not funny for anybody else, but it was pretty funny. I liked it.
Who is your favorite teacher and why?
That's a difficult one. It's kind of stuck between Dulcetti and OB. OB because she's like a mother to me, and Dulcetti because she's absolutely hilarious.
If you could be a pizza topping, what would you be and why?
Cheese, because cheese is good.
What is your funniest class memory?
That one's a hard one. I don't like this.
Mrs. Dulcetti!
just a few minutes ago when Mrs. Dulcetti called, what's his name?
Jordan?
No,
Yang Wang. The wrong way.
Who is your favorite teacher and why? Not really, because I've had most classes.
In kindergarten, I've always wanted to be a doctor,
mm-hmm.
which is a real change because I kind of plan on going to the culinary arts
mm-hmm.
like right after graduation.
I wanted to be a dancing doctor.
A dancing doctor, what does that mean?
I wanted to dance and I wanted to be a doctor and do it all at the same time.
give you a top three.
Okay.
No particular order. I'm going to have to go with Mr. Ohashi, of course, great guy. Ms. McKay. And since we're in English right now, I'll say Mr. Ohashi.
What is one word that describes you in grade 8? Or a sentence?
Mustache.
Who is your favorite teacher and why?
Madame Sajol. She's always been very supportive of me. From the time she moved here and she went by teacher to now, she's my French teacher in grade 12.
Thanks for being with us for the show this week. Now here's Bobby and the kids to show you one of the most popular dances in America, the chicken dance.
I wanted to be a world famous butterfly catcher. Probably thought that I was going to be a famous singer because I always wanted to be famous.
Can you tell me one word that described you in grade 8?
Shy.
OB, she's funny. Yeah. That's about it.
Favorite teacher, probably have to be Mr. because his pretty chill is awesome. Doesn't really like yell at you if you do anything wrong. So, yeah.
If you could be a pizza topping, what would you be and why?
Bacon. Because it's delicious.
What is one word that describes you in grade 8?
Annoying.
What has been the hardest subject for you in high school?
English, of course. Yeah.
What is your favorite Christmas song?
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. The very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special.
Where is the worst place you could be in 10 years from now?
Friends with Liam.
Still in high school.
But still living with my parents.
The worst place? I don't know. Downtown Vernon? Probably.
How long do you think you've spent drying your hands in our crappy hand dryers at our school?
Oh, I'd say probably a solid millennium.
Well, I had a really embarrassing day. First, I fell out of the truck in the morning and I slipped and I landed on my butt. And then I went to the bathroom and I was wearing a skirt and I walked around for like half an hour with my skirt tucked into my underwear. And then my bra broke, so I walked around all day trying to.
What's your favorite animal and why?
Liger.
What are you drawing?
A liger.
What's a liger?
It's my favorite animal. It's like a lion and a tiger mixed.
What is the single most important thing you've learned throughout high school?
When Travis Webster is driving, don't get in the car.
Grade 8 South, words of wisdom, what would they be?
Learn how to drift the car without going up a mountainside.
If you could give your Grade 8 South words of wisdom, what would they be?
Oh, I'm not ready for this yet.
I'm gonna film you like this and I'm gonna put this in the video because if you don't want to answer a question, this is gonna go in. If you could be one animal, what would it be and why?
Oh man, platypus for sure. I've always wanted to be a platypus. Like, just how interesting would it be to platypus? Like, would you even know what you are? Like, what do they call themselves?
Well, my most embarrassing moment was definitely when Jordan Johnson gave me some of his chocolate milk to drink and I threw it back at him and I forgot to put the lid on and I threw the chocolate milk and it showered the hallway and I was covered in sticky chocolate milk for the rest of the day. Thanks, Jordan.
Okay, who has the pop? Naveed?
Yeah. I'm having lunch.
Get out, Naveed. No pop, but lunch.
I want my lunch.
Get out! Great call. Go.
No. I have rice.
No drink.
I'd be a moose. Because I'm a moose.
Go. Woo! Okay, Kate.
Chevalier! Princess!
Oh my god!
What would you tell your grade 8 self?
Quite a few things, actually. One, boys don't matter.
The only friend that you'll ever have that actually is going to be there for you throughout everything is music. Keep that in mind. And go to class, because, yeah, friends are stupid.
Real man do. Oh my god.
I'm not so good.
No. Let me win.
So, I told my friends 10 puns, hoping that at least one of them would make them laugh. No pun intended. Get it? No pun intended.
Oh my god, can I just get a picture of you?
How do I get over there?
Because I need a picture to show Santa what I want for Christmas.
This is how we get guys. Alright.
Down here is your home. Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things are...
Alright, if you want to pass, you gotta come to class, do your homework, otherwise something wicked this way comes.
Good times.
Hot, soapy water.
Keep it clean, Jelly Bean, or you dropped an F-bomb. So who dropped this F-bomb?
Get your gym strip on, let's go!
Ah ben franchement, one minute, j'ai mon voyage, toute la gang, qui maman?
If you were stranded on a desert island, what teacher would you choose to be with and why?
Mr. Kagan, because he's funny.
Maybe Mr. Howard or Mr. Yap, some of the science teachers, because they know a lot, and I think that would be very useful.
I guess Mr. Elmont, so they can make me a boat or a raft so I can get off.
Awesome.
Hey, there's a good one, right?
I take Mr. Howard because he's smart, you probably know what to do. And I bring Karen because she's good company.
Alright, if you could have one superpower, what would you pick?
Teleportation.
Okay, Alex, because Alex is a lifeguard and she can save me if I'm gonna die. And a teacher, Okay, I don't like this game.
Mr. McGraw.
Stevens. Because I think you know what he's doing. Good survivalist.
Mr. McKay's good company.
Definitely Dulcetti. She's hilarious. She would just make the whole experience just like a blast.
Yeah, probably Dulcetti.
If you were stranded on an island and you could bring one teacher with you, who would they be?
I think it's got to be Mr. Cranenberg. Yeah, he's pretty resourceful. I think he'd be good company too.
I gotta go with Mr. Howard. I mean, that's a given. Not only is he an attractive guy, he needs somebody nice to look at, but he's a genius. He's good with the chemicals. You know, we need to make a fire, he'll make it for me.
Flying?
Why?
I don't know. Time traveling or something, maybe. I don't know.
Be a vampire?
Yeah, I could be a vampire. I'm already a vampire, but...
Definitely to fly.
Why?
Because then you can go anywhere, do anything, you know? Fast speeds.
I'd like to be like Flash, go really fast everywhere. I don't know, running on water seems really cool. So, I'd probably be it, run really fast.
What did you want to be when you were in kindergarten?
Probably a professional hockey player.
I get asked this question too much because I have a prepared answer. So I basically take Einstein's equation for E equals MC squared, so I could turn my body into pure energy or any matter into pure energy, or like take energy and turn it into matter. That being vulnerable.
If you could have a superpower, what would it be?
Invisible.
Why?
So you can do whatever you want.
Same thing, invisible.
Noah?
Next question.
If you could have one superpower, what would you choose?
To control people's minds, telepathy.
Why?
Because then I can get anyone to do whatever I want and I wouldn't have to come to school. And my life would be easier.
If I have one superpower, it's mind reading, because that way, whenever someone goes and asks you a question, you would actually know the answer. Like, the teacher's here to go, just go pick on you. And just, like, read the answer in their mind.
To run fast.
Why?
I don't know, so you run around the world.
If you were stranded on a desert island and you could pick one teacher to be with you, who would you pick and why?
I would probably pick Cranenberg, because he just seems to know the most about the valuable things.
I would fly.
Why?
Because flying is fun.
It would have to be glitter power, because when someone be like bullying you in the class, in like the halls or something, you just like pull it out of your pocket and be like, glitter, and just blow it out of them and run.
Awesome. Who is your favorite teacher and why?
Miss Dalsetti.
What?
She drags my butt to the finish line. And I wouldn't be here without Miss Dalsetti. Love her.
Who is your favorite teacher and why?
Cranenberg. He's awesome.
Who are your favorite teachers and why?
Obie. She's hilarious.
Kadash is hilarious.
Ohashi, because he always gives me food.
I say Dalsetti.
What? Why?
Because she teaches better. I understand stuff. She's funny.
All right.
I would say Miss McKay. She's funny, and I think she's the best cooking teacher. She understands like teenagers' life. Yeah, I like her.
I think it's Miss McKay. I think she's the best teacher. She's the funny teacher.
The worst place you could see yourself in 10 years?
Oh, probably still here.
Miss McKay or Mr. Cranenberg, because they're very nice.
McKay, because she's awesome and she's an awesome teacher.
Who's your favorite teacher?
What do you want to do? A firefighter. Who doesn't want to be a firefighter? That's right. In kindergarten?
Okay, what is the craziest pickup line that would work on you?
How you doing?
It doesn't have to be appropriate.
Ever take it off any sweet jumps?
What is a very embarrassing story in high school?
Probably grad auction when I was dancing like a maniac the entire time and I heard about it the next day from my little sister. Hey! All my friends were laughing hysterically at you because you were dancing like a maniac.
Describe yourself with one word of yourself in grade 8.
Shy. I don't know.
What is your favorite quote from your teacher?
Il n'y a pas de miracle.
Where's the worst place you could see yourself in 10 years?
Probably still in this classroom. When we were little, we wanted to, I was going to own the pet shop and then she was going to be the vet. And then we were going to be loaded and have animals.
I'd be spinach because it's healthy. And it's good for muscle building and stuff.
What did you want to be when you were in kindergarten?
A fire truck. I was 5, okay?
If you could be a pizza topping, what would you be? And why?
I'd have to go jalapeno, you know? It's nice and hot, you know? Spicy. It's always good.
What movie or TV show best describes your high school life?
Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets.
What would you say to your grade 8 self?
Toughen up, little girl. You'll make it through it.
It's gotta be Ohashi. I mean, I'm gonna need to stay entertained that whole time, and that he's got jokes for days.
What?
I've already done him.
What?
What would you say to your grade 8 self?
I would say, clean yourself up, and stop being such a little girl.
I wanted to be a firefighter because I like dancing around poles. And I also wanted to be a cop, so I could stop lots of crime.
What are your 3 favorite moments of French 12?
Well, being the main character in every single skit the boys ever did, that was always fun. Being serenaded with Sue Levant to the back of my head. And, you know, the gang in general, my fan club behind me.
The most embarrassing moment you can think of?
When I had to get one of the teachers to tow my car at school, because it got stuck in ice, because it's a piece of crap.
One word that described you in grade 8?
Short.
Craziest pickup line that would work on you?
Okay, I heard one, and it's a shark ate my friend. Will you be my new one?
Where is the worst place you could see yourself being in 10 years?
Probably my parents' basement playing video games.
I fell upstairs in grade 8 in front of a really hot group of guys.
We've all been through it.
Okay. Kindergarten, I wanted to be an orchestra conductor.
Probably butt naked walking down the streets of East Hastings.
What did you want to be when you were in kindergarten?
I think I wanted to be a fairy princess with Maeve McGraw.
I wanted to be a ballerina, which everyone could probably already guess.
So what did you guys want to be when you were in kindergarten?
I wanted to be a dinosaur.
I wanted to be a bus driver.
I wanted to be a veterinarian.
I want to be a fire truck. I kid you not.
So yeah.
Just making sure everyone knows my favorite quote is, hard work surpasses talent all the time.
Somewhere beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me, my lover stands on golden sand. We get it almost every night. When that moon is big and bright, it's a supernatural delight. Everybody dancing in the moonlight. Everybody here is out of sight. They don't bark and they don't bite. They keep